Hi everyone, this is Brad. Today we're taking a look at making your classroom header a little bit more personalized. Regina Peterson made a great video about this, and I just wanted to share some tips and tricks. So of course you don't have to use your Bitmoji, but of course you can. You just have to add the Bitmoji extension. Notice how kind of darkened this is. It's just so your name will stand out and your class code. So when you create it, it's going to look something like this here, but as you can see, it does get a little bit darker when you upload it. So we're going to use Google Drawings. We're going to go to New, More, Google Drawings. You're going to need to adjust the page setup, so just make sure to go to File, Page Setup, and then you're going to need to adjust it from Standard to Custom, and from Inches to Pixels, and we're going to go 1600 by 400. Then we're going to select Apply. So there you have it. Now we need a background. So we're going to go to Insert, Image, Search the Web, and we're going to type in Wall, Floor, Background. Okay, let's scroll down a little bit. One that I've found best so far that I really like is this one. You're going to double click, and then you're going to stretch it to fit the size here. So let's go ahead and do that. Move this up a little bit, and there we go. So now we have it. So I'm going to put in a blackboard here. So let's go ahead, Insert, Image, Search the Web, and I'm going to type in cartoon blackboard. Whoops, there we go. Okay, didn't even spell it right. Let's put that in there, shrink it a little bit here, and let's put it right there so it's centered. Now I'm going to insert a text box, and within here what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead in and I'm going to adjust this. I'm going to make the text color white. Let's make the font size 24. Let's make sure it's centered. And then we're going to change the font style here and just say, welcome to Mr. Dale's class. Okay, of course you can adjust this however it is you like. All right, so we'll just move this down just a little bit here. There we go, that's fine. Now we're going to put a couch in over here. So we're going to go to Insert, Image, Search the Web. Now we're going to type in transparent cartoon couch. Okay, so when we do that, one thing is this one has worked out well. Of course, you can always just click on things and then insert. That works. So does double clicking. When you do this, though, of course, it does come up huge. If you're going to use a Bitmoji, you want to make sure to kind of right click on this, and then you want to rotate it horizontally so it comes this way, because Bitmojis will face that way. And you don't want your couch floating, so let's move it down a little bit. All right, now I'm also going to insert, let's go ahead in and let's go to a transparent cartoon bookshelf. All right, of course there's lots of things you could put in. You could put in coffee, a coffee table, coffee pot, coffee mug, so whatever, you know, personalize it, make it how you like it. For example, on the one that I created before, I put some, sports things around. I put the Philly special. I put the Phillies winning the World Series. I also put over here, as you can see, my Bitmoji. So in order to do that, you'd have to add the Bitmoji extension. So I'm just going to click on it here, and I'm going to type in sit because I'm going to be sitting. And what we're going to do is we're just going to drag it down. And let's see how I look on here. Maybe a little bit large. Yeah, that's fine. Whatever. So now I just want to add a computer. So let's go ahead and do that. Insert image, search the web. Let's do transparent cartoon laptop. And if we do that, this one here, let's drag this one over. Gonna need to shrink it a little bit. Not a big deal. Let's go ahead and do that. Now that looks a little bit too large. All right, that's fine. Of course, you can go ahead in and make this work for you. Now, one thing to point out is if you're going to put pictures in the background, sometimes what does happen is this, is you may need to order some things. So you can see how it says to bring forward is this. You can see how it's in front of my face now. If you want, you just need to right click and then again, order, and you want to send it backwards. So now it's going to be behind me. So that's just something to point out. When you're ready, what you can do is go ahead, let's just close out here, and let's just pretend this was fine for me. For right now, I'm going to go ahead and go to File. I'm going to do Download as PNG Image. It's going to download to my computer. You can see it right in here. And then I'll show you what it looks like in Google Classroom. Okay, so here is an example classroom. What I want to do is I want to upload photo, and now I need to select it from my computer. And in this case, I just called it Google Classroom. Let's go ahead in and find it here. There it is. So select it right in there, select open. And now what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to drag this just a little bit here. Whoops. Move it over just a little bit. And there we have it. Now we're going to select class theme, give it a little bit of time, and there you have it. So there you go. If you do have any questions, let me know. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.